Namaste and a very good evening to all my friends here at HashLearn. My name is Uplav Kumar and today we are here for the fourth session on the topic of solid state. So hi Nisha and hi Aditya, Raj, Abu, everyone is welcome for today's class. So it's a very good sign to see that everyone is ready for today's class, right? So in today's class, we'll be talking about something that is known as the Bravais lattice. So this topic is, देखो सब लोग का कहना है कि इस चीज में आपको फिर से याद करना पड़ेगा दैट देयर 14 डिफरेंट टाइप्स ऑफ सिस्टम था आप उसको याद करो. ओके आई अग्री कि आज आपको थोड़ा याद करना पड़ेगा बट आई ट्राई टू मेक इट एज इजी फॉर यू एज पॉसिबल. सो डू ट्राई टू गो थ्रू द एंटायर क्लास एंड सी कि देखो आपको एक्चुअली कुछ समझ में आया कि नहीं आया, राइट? सो आई कैन सी दैट ऑल ऑफ द स्टूडेंट्स आर ऑलरेडी हियर एंड दे आर वेटिंग फॉर मी, राइट? सो लेट अस स्टार्ट ऑफ टुडेज क्लास बट बिफोर वी डू दैट लेट मी टेल यू समथिंग इंटरेस्टिंग, राइट? सो यू माइट नो अबाउट द 14 ब्रवाइस लैटिस, राइट? But it was not Bravais himself, but some other gentleman who's credited with discovery of these lattices. So I'll just tell you who it was. His name was Moritz Ludwig Frankenheim. So he was the first person who basically discovered the crystal lattices. After 10-15 years, basically, it got refined by Mr. Bravais, and that is why we know it by the name of Mr. Bravais only. But he's the first person who was credited with the discovery of all the crystal lattices, right? So he actually discovered 15 lattices, and today we know of only 14. So we'll come back to this fact later in today's class. But I can say that he was basically unlucky because he found one extra than what was needed. So he is basically the first person to be credited with the discovery of all the crystal lattices, right? So that is about today. So let us do a quick recap of what we did in the previous class before we start off with today's class. Hello? Yeah. Let us do a quick recap of what we did in the previous class. So in the previous class, we were talking about what is X-ray diffraction, what are X-rays, that X-rays are a type of electromagnetic waves. Now what is diffraction? So diffraction is when light bends at the edges. Now uske se kya hoga? Interference hoga if the two waves are in phase. Now if the two waves are out of phase, then they'll go for a destructive interference. So I think someone also asked, what do you mean by out of phase? So I'll just quickly tell you what is out of phase and in phase. Suppose I have two waves, okay, and if the two waves are going to the top point at the same instant and their bottoms are also at the same instant, I can say that they are in phase, right? But if suppose something happens and when one of the wave is having its top point, the other is having its bottom, right? So if one of the top interferes with this one of the bottom, then I'll say that both of them will go for a destructive interference. These type of waves are called out of phase waves, okay? So that is what we did. Then we learned about what is Bragg's law. We learned that the X-ray diffraction and Bragg's law was very important in understanding the structure of a solid, because that gave us an idea ki iska structure kaisa dikhta hai. So it was very, very important to understand ki structure ka kaisa shape hai, kya geometry hai. Not only about crystals and minerals, it also helped us to find some of the structures of some proteins, carbohydrates and so on, right? So X-ray diffraction and Bragg's law was very, very important in understanding the structure of almost all of the things. Now that is what we did in the previous class. We also derived what was Bragg's law. We did a numerical also on Bragg's law. So that is what we did in the previous class. So let us, I hope ki kisi ko kuch doubt nahi hoga kal ke class se. Okay, and I do not want Priyanshu and Aditya to be fighting here. Please do not fight. Yeah, thank you Bodhi, you shouldn't be fighting over here. We have come here to learn about the fourth class of solid state, that is about the unit cells and lattices. So please be with me and there's no need to fight. Aditya, don't talk in between, you're not a lawyer, okay? Please Aditya, do not get involved in a fight. We are here to learn, and we are here to learn chemistry, not to fight. So that is what we did in the previous class. Let us do a quick summary of what we are going to do in today. So today we are going to talk about what are unit cells, what are crystal systems, what are lattices, what do you mean by a 1D lattice, what do you mean by a 2D lattice, what do you mean by 3D lattice, and what are different types of 3D lattices, right? So this is all what we are going to do in today's class. So let me just start off with the first thing. I don't understand why people are getting so worked up in the comment section. So I'm seeing Dwij, Bodhi and Aditya, Raj, Priyanshu. Why are you guys fighting? Please just focus on the class. There's no need to interact with yourself, with each other ये सब चीज को लेके कि कौन क्या बोल रहे हैं, प्लीज बी काम एंड ट्राई टू फोकस ऑन द क्लास इटसेल्फ. इट विल बी वेरी हेल्पफुल बिकॉज आज का टॉपिक इज सपोज टू बी वेरी बोरिंग. सबको ऐसा लगता है कि बहुत बोरिंग टॉपिक है, बट आई विल शो यू व्हाट इज द इंपॉर्टेंस ऑफ दिस पर्टिकुलर टॉपिक. ओके, सो फर्स्ट ऑफ ऑल यू गोइंग टू लर्न अबाउट व्हाट आर क्रिस्टल्स, देन विल टॉक अबाउट व्हाट डू यू मीन बाय अ लैटिस, एंड देन विल टॉक अबाउट व्हाट आर यूनिट सेल्स. Because these terms are very frequently used in the entire chapter of solid state. तो आपको ये सब चीज पता होनी चाहिए कि क्रिस्टल क्या होता है, लैटिस क्या होता है, यूनिट सेल क्या होता है. सो क्रिस्टल इज बेसिकली अ शॉर्ट फॉर्म फॉर क्रिस्टलाइन सॉलिड्स. सो ऑल क्रिस्टलाइन सॉलिड्स आर कॉल्ड क्रिस्टल्स, राइट? सो व्हाट आर क्रिस्टलाइन सॉलिड्स? आई कैन से क्रिस्टलाइन सॉलिड्स आर दोज सॉलिड्स इन विच द पार्टिकल्स आर अरेंज्ड इन सम ज्योमेट्रिकल पैटर्न, राइट? सो व्हाट आर क्रिस्टल्स? क्रिस्टल्स आर होमोजीनियस सब्सटेंस. होमोजीनियस तो होने ही बिकॉज इट विल बी रिपीटेड थ्रू आउट. So crystals are homogeneous substance in which the geometrical pattern, in which the particles are arranged in some geometrical pattern, right? So I can take an example like this. So this entire thing as a whole, right? So what I am drawing is the microscopic level, ki particles kaise arranged hai. When you look at this substance from a macroscopic view, to aapko substance as a whole dikhega, right? So that substance as a whole is what we call as a crystal. So this entire thing is what we call as a crystal. Now the shape or the structure this crystal is taking is called lattice, right? So lattice for all purpose is basically equal to structure. So just aap simply yaad rakho ye cheez ki lattice ka dusra matlab hota hai structure. So what is the structure of a crystal? That is what we know as lattice. तो आप देखो लैटिस के साथ और भी कुछ पॉइंट्स होते हैं. व्हाट आर लैटिस पॉइंट्स? तो इफ आई टेक दिस एग्जांपल, तो इस एग्जांपल में आप देखो कि हम लोग द मॉलिक्यूल्स आर अरेंज्ड इन अ रेक्टेंगुलर मैनर, राइट? सो आई कैन सी दैट दिस क्रिस्टल हैज अ रेक्टेंगुलर लैटिस, राइट? एंड ऑल ऑफ दीज पॉइंट्स आर कॉल्ड लैटिस पॉइंट्स. So I hope किसी को ये डाउट नहीं हो कि what do you mean by lattice and what do you mean by lattice points. Lattice is simply another word for structure, and lattice points are the points that will basically make up the structure, right? What is a crystal? The crystal is the entire substance which is usually a short form for crystalline solids. Okay. Now unit cell क्या होता है? Unit cell is the smallest cell that can show you the complete arrangement of the atom, right? For example, इस case में what is the arrangement? The arrangement is rectangular. So can I say that if I take only this much, I'll use a different color. Suppose I use only this much, fine. If I take only this thing, can I say that इसको अगर मैं extend कर दूँ हर direction में, I'll get my crystal, I'll get the entire lattice, right? So the smallest unit which on repetition will give you the crystal is called the unit cell, right? So if you guys want to take it down, please write the smallest unit. Right, the smallest structure which when repeated in every direction will give you the entire crystal is called the unit cell. So I'll just write it for you guys. If you want to take a note of it, please take a note of it. The smallest structure which when repeated gives the crystal. So देखो the smallest structure which when repeated, now repeated where? Repeated in all sides, right? So the smallest structure which when repeated in all sides gives us the crystal, that structure is known as a unit cell. तो अगर आपको कोई भी crystal को समझना है तो आपको उसका एक unit cell को निकालना होगा. And try to study use unit cell ke kya property hai, kaisa structure hai. The same structure will be followed in the entire crystal, right? So that is what we mean by crystals, lattice and unit cells. I hope no one has any doubt in this thing. Okay, so Raman is actually saying that it is a very interesting topic. Okay, Raman, I hope you have already understood this topic because mujhe to pehle bahut boring lagta tha. But when I just studied this thing more recently, it is not that boring actually. Okay, so just be with us and you'll see that it is not actually that boring a topic. Okay. So I hope crystals, lattice and unit cells everyone has understood. Okay, unit cell is the smallest part of a crystal which will show the structure of the substance, and if I repeat the unit cell in all directions, I'll get my crystal, right? So unit cell and crystal are done. Lattice is simply another word for structure, and all the points in the structure are known as lattice points. Okay? So if you guys want to take a note of it, please take a note of it. And how last in yesterday there was a confusion that whether sir is going on live or recorded version. So actually I was just answering on a different channel. So today I think most of you guys will be seeing my responses. So don't worry, every class that is happening on HashLearn is a live lecture. Don't think I'm going to record karke dal rahe, because if you are going to do that, we'll just say it. There's no need to say ki live and then you're giving you recorded. Okay? So if you want to see whether it's live or not, please put in your comments and see that we are going to interact with you. Okay. Okay, now, so we know what is a unit cell, now we know what's a lattice, and we know what's a crystal. Now, what do we mean by a 1D lattice? So, let us start off with a 1D lattice. So, lattice means structure. Now, that structure that is existent in only one dimension is called a 1D lattice. What simple? So, that structure that is existent in only one dimension. So, this is an example of a 1D lattice. So I can say that this thing as a whole is the crystal. If I take one of them, this will be my unit cell, because isko aap dono side mein repeat karo, then you will get the entire crystal. So this is my unit cell. This entire thing is my crystal. And what is the lattice? What is the structure of this particular thing? The structure is linear, right? So I hope 1D lattice to bahut simple hai. Everyone has understood this thing. Okay, so Priyanshu is asking, sir, is this topic having any weightage in JEE? So Priyanshu, yes, this chapter will have some weightage in JEE, because iske dekho, isme jo humne padhenge, that is very objective in nature. So they can simply ask you about one of the lattice system and tell about its property. For example, if you would have known ki aaj ke hum log padhne wale, then we'll be talking about some lattices. So if I simply ask you, what is the property of a tetrahedral lattice? Agar aapko nahi pata, you won't be able to answer, right? So, इस चैप्टर से अराउंड इस टॉपिक से वन क्वेश्चन एक क्वेश्चन या दो क्वेश्चन आ सकते हैं. इट्स नॉट वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, बट द नॉलेज ऑफ दिस थिंग विल हेल्प यू इन द नेक्स्ट टॉपिक दैट इज रिलेटेड टू द अदर यूनिट सेल्स एंड द पैकिंग फ्रैक्शन, राइट? सो प्लीज ट्राई टू अंडरस्टैंड दिस थिंग. एग्जाम पर्सपेक्टिव से इट्स नॉट वेरी वेरी इंपॉर्टेंट, बट क्वेश्चन कैन कम फ्रॉम दिस पर्टिकुलर टॉपिक. सो जस्ट गो थ्रू दिस थिंग. ओके, राइट? ओके, राइट. सो आई एम सीइंग दैट एवरीवन इज एबल टू अंडरस्टैंड दिस थिंग. सो लेट अस मूव ऑन टू द नेक्स्ट पार्ट. That is the 2D lattice. So 2D lattice is where the fun starts. So just keep an eye on this thing ki hum log kya pad rahe hain yahan pe. So 2D lattice. So basically a structure that is existent in two dimensions is called a 2D lattice. So let us see ki kya kya different combinations possible hai. Now one combination that is very symmetrical and is very very possible is like this. तो देखो, आपको जब भी एक स्ट्रक्चर को डिफाइन करना है, आपको उसका जब भी इसके बारे में डिस्क्रिप्शन देना है, तो अगर 1D में आप कर रहे हो, then what is the only thing that you need to know? Suppose this is a 1D lattice. अगर आपको किसी को बताना है कि इसका स्ट्रक्चर कैसा है, then what is the information that you need to have to describe this lattice? Can you tell me? Okay, so I'm looking at the comments. Can you tell me what information do I need to tell someone if I want to describe this particular structure? Okay, come on. So I don't think I am able to see this thing. Okay, so basically dekho, agar aapko isko structure ko define karna hai ya describe karna hai kisi ko bhi, you just need to tell in dono ke beech mein difference kya hai. Agar in dono ke beech mein difference hai d, can I say that in dono ke beech mein difference bhi d hoga? This will also be d, this will also be d, and this will also be d. So to describe this 1D lattice, I need to have only one information, that is, what is the distance between the two atoms, right? So for similarly, if I want to describe a 2D lattice, what information do I need? What information will I need to describe this particular lattice? So I can say, to describe any 2D lattice, I need to have three information. First, what is the length? Let it be A. What is the breadth? Let it be B. And what is the angle between them? Let that be theta. That's it. So I can say, to describe a 2D lattice, I need to have two lengths, that is the length of the two axes, and what is the angle between them, right? So this is one type of 2D lattice that is possible. So dekho, isme special kya hai? In this case, I can say that this is A, this is B, and this is the angle between them, theta, right? So when A is equal to B and theta is equal to 90 degree, so I'll say A is equal to B and theta is equal to 90 degree, तो ये किस तरह के शेप का हो सकता है प्रॉपर्टी, विच टाइप ऑफ प्रॉपर्टी, विच टाइप ऑफ शेप विल हैव ए इक्वल टू बी एंड थीटा इक्वल टू 90 डिग्री, कम ऑन, ओके निशा, या यू टोल्ड दैट डी विल बी सेम, इट्स करेक्ट, सो कैन यू टेल मी विच टाइप ऑफ थिंग विल हैव ए इक्वल टू बी एंड थीटा इक्वल टू 90 डिग्री, ओके, सो या विनीत एंड राजेश, यू आर सेइंग यूनिट सेल, सो या यूनिट सेल, बट उसको डिस्क्राइब करने के लिए आई नीड टू टेल कि दोनों यूनिट सेल के बीच में कितना डिस्टेंस है, राइट, सो दैट इज व्हाई आई एम सेइंग दैट इफ आई नीड टू डिस्क्राइब दिस थिंग आई जस्ट नीड टू टेल कि दोनों एटम के बीच में कितना डिस्टेंस है, राइट, सो फॉर दिस टाइप ऑफ सेटअप व्हाट विल यू कॉल द सेल, राइट, व्हिच इज हैज गिवन द करेक्ट आंसर, द थिंग विल बी कॉल्ड अ स्क्वायर लैटिस, बिकॉज इट इज, इसका शेप क्या है, स्क्वायर की जैसा, स्क्वायर के सब साइड्स इक्वल होते हैं एंड उनके बीच में एंगल कितना होता है 90 डिग्री, सो दिस इज वन टाइप ऑफ लैटिस दैट इज पॉसिबल. Let me draw another one. Now suppose I draw something like this. So dekho, dono mein similarity bhi hai, dono different bhi hai. What is the similarity in both of them? I can say that in dono cases mein, the layers ke jo centers hai, they are aligned with each other. So I can say this is a type of packing in which the center of the first layer and the center of the second layer are aligned. Can you say that? That is even aligned with the third layer. इस केस में भी देखो वही हो रहा है. The center of the first layer and the center of the second layer and the center of the third layer, they are aligned to each other. So I can say both of them are similar. But I can say in this case, this distance and this distance are not the same, right? Because the width between them is more than the length. So I can say in this case, A is not equal to B, right? In this case, A is not equal to B, but theta will be equal to 90 degree. So I hope sab koi mereko bata sakti ki ye kis tarah ka shape hai. I'm looking at the comments. Okay, so Kabir and Raman also told it's a square. Mansi, it can't be a cube because it's only in two dimension. Just try to keep that in mind. You're talking about two dimension now, and cube is a 3D thing. Okay. Bodhi also said the same thing. Not a cubic lattice yet. We are not talking about the 3D thing. So please tell me kya hoga iska answer. So if this sort of thing is happening, I can say it is a rectangular lattice, right? So basically do cover ho gaya hamare 2D lattice mein. Let's see what are the different types of, what are the other types of 2D lattice. I hope in dono mein kisi ko koi doubt nahi hoga. To dekho, pehla do ka property ye tha ki their centers were aligned with each other. Ab dekho second type ka kis unit jo banega, jo lattice banega, usme kya hoga. So now this sort of thing will happen, jisme the center of the second layer will not be aligned with the first and third. So I can say this is different from this type of structure, right? Now if this distance and this distance are equal, suppose this and this are equal, then this angle will be equal to 60 degree, right? So this is what we call as a hexagonal, called a hexagonal lattice. When this and this are equal, because hexagonal ka jo sides bante hain, I'll just show you how it is formed. So if this side and this side are equal, right, basically ye bhi equal hoga. So if all of these sides are equal, then it will form a hexagonal lattice. So iska condition kya hai, A should be equal to B and this angle, this theta should be equal to 120 degree. Very good, Rajeshi and Nisha. You all told me hexagonal, right? So this is what is the third type of lattice. I hope everyone has understood this thing. Because at any point of time, if you don't understand, don't worry. All of the videos are available in the recorded format. So you can go back to the video anytime and every time you want it. So just keep an eye out ki main kya padha raha hu. If you have any doubt, put that in the comment. Let us see how we can help you in that case. Okay. Now, similar to this, but thoda difference ke saath, there is another structure that is possible. Now, suppose करें एक ऐसा है जिसमें this distance and this distance are not the same, right? तो in that case it won't be hexagonal lattice. So this type of lattice is called a rectangular lattice with a central point, right? This type of lattice is called a rectangular lattice with central point. So A is equal to B and theta is equal to 90 degree, but this rectangular will have a central point, right? So this is a, you can say, a variation of the rectangular lattice because it has a central point. So we have covered four types of 2D lattice now. There's only one remaining. Okay, Aditya, so you even said sorry to Dwij. I'm really liking Aditya and Dwij for being so open about it. देखो लड़ाई करने कोई प्रॉब्लम नहीं है, बट ट्राई अंडरस्टैंड कि यहाँ पे हम लोग लड़ने नहीं आए. वी आर हियर टू अंडरस्टैंड, वी आर हियर टू लर्न, राइट? सो प्लीज ट्राई टू कीप अ गुड एनवायरमेंट अमंग योरसेल्फ्स एंड इन द चैट स्क्रीन सो दैट यू कैन ऑल कम हियर एंड स्टडी एंड गेट समथिंग आउट ऑफ इट. आपका टाइम यहाँ पे आपको वेस्ट नहीं करना है. ओके, दैट इज वन मोर टाइप ऑफ 2D लैटिस. तो इसका ज्यादा लॉजिक नहीं है. दिस लुक्स लाइक अ पैरेललोग्राम. So this type of lattice is called a parallelogram. So I can say ki isme the centers are not like this and the centers are not even like the square or tetrahedron or the rectangular, because it's thoda oblique jaisa dikh raha hai. So this is known as parallelogram, or it is also known as oblique lattice, right? So these are the five types of 2D lattice. I hope everyone has understood ki what are the five types of 2D lattice. I'll just tell what are the five things again. One is a square lattice. Second is a rectangular lattice. Third is a hexagonal lattice in which A is equal to B and the angle between them is 120 degree. Next is a rectangular lattice with a internal point. And the fifth is a parallelogram that is also known as oblique lattice, right? Okay, so we have completed the first half of today's class. We learned what is a 1D lattice, what's a 2D lattice, what's a unit cell, what's a crystal, what's a lattice, right? So let me just tell you the, I have to announce the winner for the previous class contest winner. So the contest winner is Neerad. And the question was related to who won, in which year did the father-son duo of William H. Bragg and William L. Bragg win the Nobel Prize? So the answer was 1915. And it was, I think the option B was the correct answer. And Neerad is the person who gave the quickest right answer. So congratulations, Neerad. You'll be getting a free Atom session and it will be credited to your account. And now it's time for today's contest question. So aapko sabko fir se ek mauka milega. So the question will be appearing on your screen right now. Do attempt everyone and let's see who is getting the correct answer today. So today's question is related to symmetry and unsymmetry. So the question is something like, agar aapke jo atoms wo symmetry, jo lattice ko bana rahe, unke sizes same nahi hai, then it won't have symmetry. So which of the particular systems is the least symmetrical? So humne ye abhi tak padha nahi hai abhi tak, but this is what something you should have known agar aap aaj ke class ke liye prepare karke aate hain, right? So that is what will happen in every day whenever you're coming for a class, right? Do have a read us bare mein ki what are the particular things that we are going to study. So aap will be better prepared for today's, for any class, and you'll be able to take more out of any class, right? So please come with your this thing. Okay, so I can see people giving their answers. Okay, so let us see who will be the winner of today's contest question. The winner will be announced tomorrow. So please, you can come back for tomorrow again, right? So now let's go back to today's class. So what we have already completed, what is the 1D lattice and 2D lattice. Let us go back to the 3D lattice now. And 3D lattice is where it becomes tough. So zyada tough nahi hoga. कुछ कुछ चीज आपको थोड़ा याद करना पड़ेगा, बट मोस्ट ऑफ थिंग्स आर वेरी इजी टू अंडरस्टैंड. सो लेट अस टॉक अबाउट 3D लैटिस नाउ. तो देखो 3D लैटिस में आपको एक चीज पता होगा, दैट देयर आर 7 टाइप्स ऑफ क्रिस्टल सिस्टम. देयर आर 7 टाइप्स ऑफ क्रिस्टल सिस्टम जिसमें वेरिएशंस हैं व्हिच गिव्स यू 14 टाइप्स ऑफ ब्रोवाइस लैटिस, राइट? सो दिस इज व्हाट वी नो ऑलरेडी. अब देखो पहले लेट्स गो थोड़ा हम लोग उससे और पहले की बात करते हैं. व्हेन यू आर टॉकिंग अबाउट एनी यूनिट सेल, राइट, अ यूनिट सेल कैन बी ऑफ टू टाइप्स. इट कैन आइदर बी अ प्रिमिटिव यूनिट सेल और इट कैन बी अ नॉन प्रिमिटिव यूनिट सेल. नाउ प्रिमिटिव यूनिट सेल इज दैट यूनिट सेल व्हिच हैज एटम्स ओनली एट द कॉर्नर, राइट? सो इफ आई ड्रॉ एन यूनिट सेल लाइक दिस, and there are atoms at all of the corners, then this type of unit cell is called a primitive unit cell. Fine. Now, non-primitive unit cell is something which will have atoms definitely at the corner and kahin aur bhi hoga. Right? So, there are three variations in that. One is called a body-centered non-primitive unit cell. Next is called a face-centered non-primitive cell. And another one is called edge-centered unit cell. Now, body-centered unit cell is that cell jiske body center mein hota hai. Body center is where the body diagonals meet. Face-centered unit cell is that unit cell jiske har phase mein ek atom hoga. Like here, here, here. So, six faces, each of them will have a atom in the center. Right? Edge-centered is basically a special type of face center jisme bas ek pair of opposite phases mein atom honge. Right? So, these are the types of unit cell. So, I hope everyone has understood ki what are the different types of unit cell. Unit cell can either be a primitive unit cell or a non-primitive unit cell. Now, non-primitive unit cells are of three types. Body-centered unit cell jisme ek atom hota at the body center. Now, where is the body center? The body center is at the body where the body diagonals meet. Face-centered will have six atoms on each of the six faces of the unit cell. Edge-centered will have two atoms at only two of the opposite faces, like this. Ya to yahan aur yahan hoga, ya yahan aur yahan, ya andar aur bahar. Right? So these are types of unit cell. Now let us talk about what are different types of crystal systems. So the crystal systems are basically categorized depending on what is the type of relationship between the different axes and what is the difference between the angles. Okay, just like 2D lattice ko define karne ke liye, what we needed A, B and the angle between them, right? So for a 3D lattice, what do we need? We need A, B, C and the angles between them, right? So let us start with the most symmetrical system. And from there, we can go to the least symmetrical. Okay, so can anyone tell me what is the most symmetrical system? Can anyone tell me which is the most symmetrical system? Okay, I'm looking at the comments. Okay, so I don't think anyone is answering it. So let us just continue anyways. The most symmetrical system will be that system which will have all the sides equal and the angles between them will be equal to 90 degree. So this type of system is called a cubic system, right? Now second case kya hoga? Dekho, hum log yahi se change kar karke dusra systems layenge. Is case mein kya tha? All the three sides are equal and all the angles are 90 degree. Agar three ke jagah two sides are equal, then it is called a tetrahedral lattice. In a tetrahedral lattice, what happens? A is equal to B, but these are not equal to C. But the angles are still equal to 90 degree. Right? So the most symmetrical is cubic. After that comes tetrahedral. Now, after tetrahedral mein kya ki two sides are equal but they are not equal to third side but the angles are 90. The third type of system is one in which none of the sides are equal. That type of system is called orthorhombic. Right? And orthorhombic mein kya hota hai? A is not equal to B which is not equal to C but all the angles are 90 degree. Okay? So we discussed out of the seven, we have discussed about the three of the crystal systems. So, dekho, abhi kya tha? All sides are equal, all angles are 90. Next kya aya? Two sides are equal and all angles are 90. Isme kya tha? No sides are equal but all angles are 90. Let's look at the fourth system. The fourth system is called rhombohedral. So, dekho, rhombohedral ko yaad karne ka bahut hi simple tarika hai. Suppose karo aapka se cube hai, right? If you distort that cube in all the three axes, fine. If you distort the cube in all the three axes, kya hoga? Its sides will remain the same. The length of the sides will remain the same, but can I say that all the angles will change? Right? None of the angles will now have 90 degree. Right? So that type of system in which all the sides are equal, but the angles are not equal to 90 degree is called a rhombohedral lattice, right? Next, we have monoclinic system. Now, monoclinic system is that system in which two angles are 90 and none of the sides are equal. So, monoclinic mein kya hota hai ki two angles are equal to 90 degree, the third is not 90 and A is not equal to B, B is not equal to C, right? Third type of system, or the least symmetrical system, is the triclinic system. That was the question for today's contest. So, jisko bhi jisne bhi sahi answer diya, they will be getting a free atom session. We'll announce the winner tomorrow. So, the least symmetrical system is the triclinic system because none of the angles are equal to 90 and none of the sides are equal, right? So, these are the six types of crystal systems. I hope everyone has understood what are the different types of crystal system. There's one more type of crystal system. I'll just draw that thing because wo sabko pata hi hoga. For some reason, I'm not able to see any comments. So, are you guys not commenting or am I not able to see it? I don't really know. Right? So, this is the last type of crystal system that we have to discuss. This type of crystal system is called a hexagonal crystal system. So, dekho, iske property kya hoti hai? This side and this side will be equal. Okay? As in, this side and this side will be equal. All of these sides are equal. Right? So, the sides in the same plane are equal, but they are different from this particular side. So, I can say A is equal to B and both of them are not equal to C. Now, angles ka dekho kya hota hai? One angle will be 90. I can say one angle is equal to 90 and the other angles are how much? The other angles will be 120 degree. So, that crystal system which has two sides equal but not equal to a third and the angles in this form is the seventh type of crystal system which is called hexagonal system, right? So, these are the seven types of the crystal systems. I hope everyone's understood ki what are the seven types of crystal system. So, dekho, seven types of crystal system hota hai, but 14 types of Bravais lattice hota hai. Now, this is happening because agar aap cubic ki baat kare to cubic is this thing, right? But cubic ke bhi different variations ho sakte hai. For example, you can have a body-centered cubic cell, you can have a face-centered cubic cell, you can have an edge-centered unit cell, right? For the same thing, aapko tetrahedral mein bhi different variations ho sakte hai, orthorhombic mein different variations ho sakte hai, rhombo mein bhi ho sakte hai, monoclinic mein bhi ho sakte hai, and triclinic mein bhi ho sakte hai. So, ho sab mein sakte variations, that gives us 14 Bravais lattice, and I think you'll be seeing an image of that thing very soon on your screen. So, the screen will be filled with an image that will have the 14 Bravais lattice. So, I want everyone to just very carefully look at these 14 Bravais lattice. So, dekho 14 hai, but 7 crystal systems are there. Okay. And you need to tell me ki kitne sare kaun se hai. Okay. So, I'll be rubbing this thing off. So, what were the 7 crystal systems? I'll just have a look. You can just keep watching at that image. So, keep looking at the image. Aap log dhyan se dekho usme kya kya different varieties hai. We'll be talking about that very soon. So, keep have a look at that image. And I will ask you ki kis mein kis kis type of variations hai, okay? So, this image will also be in your books and also I hope everyone has an idea about this thing. So, let us now talk about all of these things. So, you can remove the image now. Okay. Now, cubic mein kis tarah ke hote hai? Cubic mein teen tarah ke variations hote hai. What are the three variations? You can have a simple unit cell, you can have a body-centered unit cell and you can have a face-centered unit cell. Right? So, one cubic has three variations. These are the three variations. Tetrahedral mein do hote hai. Right? So, you can have a simple unit cell and you can have an edge centered, or sorry, you can have a body centered unit cell. Orthorhombic में चार variation होते हैं, सबसे ज्यादा variation होते हैं orthorhombic में, वो चार क्या क्या हो सकते हैं? Body centered, face centered, edge centered and simple unit cell. Okay? Rhombohedral में बस एक होता है, monoclinic में दो होते हैं. What are the two? Simple unit cell and edge centered unit cell. Right? So let's count की total कितना हुआ? 3 + 2 = 5. 5 + 4 = 9 + 1 = 10 + 2 = 12. तो हमने दो लैटिस को मिस कर दिया. व्हाट आर द टू लैटिसेस? ट्राइक्लिनिक. देयर इज वन टाइप ऑफ ट्राइक्लिनिक एंड देयर इज वन टाइप ऑफ हेक्सागोनल. राइट? सो दीस टोटल आर द 14 ब्रेविस लैटिस दैट वी आर सपोज टू स्टडी. सो आई होप एवरीवन हैज अंडरस्टूड व्हाट आर डिफरेंट वैरायटीज प्रेजेंट हियर. ओके? सो द 7 क्रिस्टल सिस्टम्स वेयर अगेन व्हाट? Cubic, tetrahedral, orthorhombic, rhombohedral, monoclinic, triclinic and hexagonal. Which is the most symmetrical? The most symmetrical is cubic because it has all the sides equal and all the angles are equal to 90 degree. Which is the least symmetrical? The least symmetrical is triclinic because none of the sides are equal and none of the angles are equal to 90 degree. Okay? Right? So there's one thing that many fact when we are talking about the starting of the class, I told you that Mr. Frankenheim is the person who actually gave us 15 lattices, but Brevais is the one who is credited with all of this. So dekho hua kya tha, there was a very sad story I can say in that case. So what happened? Mr. Frankenheim, I think in the year of 1835. So Mr. Frankenheim. Mr. Frankenheim discovered these lattices in the year of 1835, right? तो उन्होंने अपने साइड से बोला कि there are 15 crystal lattice. Now what happened? Mr. Brevais, he was also studying the same thing, right? And he acknowledged in the year 1848. In 1848, Mr. Brevais acknowledged that Mr. Frankenheim has given us 15 crystal lattices that are different from each other. But what happened? A few years later, Brevais again inspected the 15 crystal lattice and he found that two of the crystal lattice are basically the same thing, right? So because of which, what happened? They were not 15 distinct crystal lattice, but there were only 14 distinct crystal lattice. Now, ye galti kaise hua hoga? You'll be seeing an image on the screen and that will help you understand ki kaise ye hua hai. So I'll explain this thing, don't worry. So this is an example of a face-centered tetragonal. Okay, this is an example of a face-centered tetragonal. So, dekho, face-centered tetragonal is not one of the 14 Brevais lattice. Because for something to be called a Brevais lattice, it can't be identical to any existing Brevais lattice. So, agar aap log image ko bahut carefully dekho, in the image you can see that this face-centered cubic lattice has a smaller lattice, which is a body-centered tetragonal lattice. So, the lines you can see very clearly, andar mein lines aapko dikh rahe honge. The face centers on the top. Right. So what basically you are seeing on the screen is there are two face centers tetragonal lattice that are attached to each other. So the face centers and the corner atoms, agar aap un sabko join karo, then you'll be getting a body centered tetragonal lattice which is already existed. So aapko yaad rakhna hoga unit cell kya hota hai, the smallest unit. So is case mein agar aap dekho face centered ke case mein, to bada case mein to okay, this is the bigger unit cell. But can I say that us bade unit cell ke andar ek chota unit cell is already present? And that unit cell is already defined as a body-centered tetragonal lattice. So this was a type of mistake that Mr. Frankenheim did. He basically counted 15 lattice out of which two of them were similar. So Mr. Brevais, he actually corrected this thing and he told that no, only 14 lattices are distinct because one of the lattices is already similar to some other existing lattice. Right? So because of this reason, Mr. Brevais is the person who is credited with the discovery of the 14 lattices. And nowadays we know all of these lattices as Brevais lattice, right? So it's very sad for Mr. Frankenheim that he made a small error, but thankfully that error was corrected by Mr. Brevais and he is the person who is credited with all the 14 lattices, right? So that's it for today's class, right? So what all we did, I'll just do a quick summary, quick recap of what we did in today's class. So we first started off with what are crystals, then we learned what are lattice, we also learned what are unit cells. हमने डिफाइन किया यूनिट सेल को. सो यूनिट सेल इज द स्मॉलेस्ट सब्सटेंस और स्मॉलेस्ट स्ट्रक्चर विच डिफाइंस द शेप ऑफ अ सब्सटेंस. तो अगर आप इस यूनिट सेल को हर डायरेक्शन में रिपीट कर दो, देन यू विल गेट द एंटायर क्रिस्टल. सो द क्रिस्टल इज अ मैक्रोस्कोपिक क्वांटिटी, द यूनिट सेल इज अ माइक्रोस्कोपिक क्वांटिटी, राइट. व्हाट इज लैटिस? लैटिस सिंपली अनदर वर्ड फॉर स्ट्रक्चर. देन वी लर्न व्हाट इज अ 1D लैटिस. सो टू डिफाइन अ 1D लैटिस यू नीड व्हाट? यू नीड ओनली वन डिस्टेंस बिटवीन द टू एटम्स. देन वी लर्न अबाउट 2D लैटिस. सो टू डिफाइन अ 2D लैटिस यू नीड 3 थिंग्स. यू नीड द 2 लेंथ्स एंड द एंगल बिटवीन देम, राइट. Then we talked about that there are 5 types of 2D lattice. What are the 5 types? Square, rectangular, rectangular with an internal point. Then there was an hexagonal, and the final one was parallelogram or oblique. Then we had a contest. I think everyone was able to answer that thing. After that, we talked about what are different types of unit cells. So there are 2 types of unit cell. One is a primitive unit cell which has atoms only at the corner. Second is a non-primitive unit cell which has atoms at the corner. And अगर एटम एट द बॉडी सेंटर हुआ, इट विल बी कॉल्ड अ बॉडी सेंटर्ड यूनिट सेल. अगर एटम एट द फेस सेंटर्स आर आल्सो देयर, देन इट विल बी कॉल्ड अ फेस सेंटर्ड यूनिट सेल. एंड अगर एटम्स आर ओनली एट 2 ऑफ द ऑपोजिट फेसेस, इट्स कॉल्ड एन एज सेंटर्ड यूनिट सेल. देन वी डिस्कस दैट देयर आर 7 टाइप्स ऑफ क्रिस्टल सिस्टम. नाउ हाउ डू वी डिफाइन देम? तो उनका जो 3 एक्सिस होगा, उनके बीच में रिलेशन क्या है एंड उनके बीच में एंगल्स क्या है, डिपेंडिंग ऑन दैट वी डिफाइन 7 टाइप्स ऑफ क्रिस्टल सिस्टम. ऑफ विच the most stable crystal system is cubic, in which all the sides are equal and all the angles are equal to 90 degree. The second most symmetrical will be tetragonal, in which 2 sides are equal and all the angles are 90 degree. The third is orthorhombic, in which no sides are equal but all angles are 90 degree. Then we are talking about rhombohedral, in which none of the angles are 90 but all of the sides are equal. Then we talked about monoclinic, in which none of the sides are equal but 2 angles are 90. And the least symmetrical was triclinic, in which none of the sides were equal and none of the angles were equal to 90 degree. We also saw what is a hexagonal lattice, in which 2 sides will be equal. The third side will be the one between the 2 layers, right? So this side will obviously be not equal to the bottom 2 sides. And the angle between this and this will be 90, and the angle between these two will be 120 degree. Then we saw what are the 14 types of Breweis lattice and why Mr. Frankenheim did a mistake. You know, 15 lattice by that when it's actually only 14, right? So that's it for today's class. So I think there was a question in the previous class CPP, in which most of you were wrong. So that question is related to what is the use of Bragg's law and X-ray diffraction. I think the options were electronegativity, qualitative analysis and quantitative analysis, and all of these. So this was the question from the previous CPP, the third session's CPP, in which most of you were going wrong. So I don't see any reason why you went wrong there, because it's very simple. I told you multiple times in this class, the use of Bragg's law and X-ray diffraction is to find out what is the structure of a solid, right? So if I'm talking about the structure of a solid, I'm not looking at how many atoms are there, but rather I'm looking at ki wo jo atoms present hai, wo kis shape mein hai, right? So if I'm talking only about the shape, I'm looking at the quality of the substance. I'm not looking at kitne atoms hai. Hence, Bragg's law and X-ray diffraction helps us in doing a qualitative analysis, right? So that was about the previous class CPP. Now, I think you'll be getting your class practice problems right now. So, I want all the password users to start answering these questions right now. So, dekho hota kya hai? If most of you are going to answer it, then I'll get a question in which most of you will be going wrong. And I'll be discussing that question in tomorrow's class. So, agar aap sab attempt karoge, to aapko do cheez pata chalega. Whether aapne jo sahi kiya, baaki log ne galat kiya ki nahi kiya. Ya phir agar aapne galat kiya, to kitne log ne aur galat kiya. Right? So, I want everyone to start attempting the questions right away. It will hardly take 5 minutes, and these questions will challenge all the things that we learned in today's class, and it will also be very helpful in your competitive exams, right? So that's it for today's class. I will see you again tomorrow, same time. I think not tomorrow. You can see the schedule when our next class is. So in the next class, we'll be talking about what is nearest neighbors and what is the relationship between the radius of an atom and the edge length of a unit cell. So that all of this will be covered in the next class. See you guys tomorrow, or whenever our next class is. Till then, bye.